Most USB capture devices with this form factor are USB 2 and 1080p. But this Syllable is USB 3 and 4K. I'll check it out and see how good it works. That's coming up on ThriftyAV. I want to start by saying that this Syllable USB 3 HDMI capture device is a sample product that was sent to ThriftyAV for review. That being said, the folks at Syllable can request this back if they want it. I have not been paid for this review, and any opinions expressed during this video are my own. Let's take a look at the packaging on the Syllable 4K USB 3 capture device. Syllable brand HDMI video capture U900 Pro. USB 3 has 4K input and output, UVC standard, no external power required, and compatible with OBS, Windows, Linux, Mac. Here's the system requirements: Android, Windows 7, 8, 10, Mac OS, Linux. They put the Intel CPU requirement, but I'm sure this will work with AMD. On the graphics requirement, it's hard to tell what's above these graphic cards, but if you have a modern graphic card, it should work, and they want you to have 4 gigabytes of RAM. This item is taped shut. Here is the capture device. We have a USB-C adapter, and here's some instructions in English, and it's not very long. Now let's plug this into my Windows 10 machine and see if it's detected. All right, plugging the capture device into USB 3, setting up a device, 4K HD capture. I don't have anything plugged in right now, so it says no video. Let's plug a signal in. On the computer, I have this set to 3840 by 2160. That is 4K. I have a Panasonic HCX-1000 camera with an HDMI output, and that HDMI output is currently set to 4K 30. I have the HDMI plugged into my computer behind me here, and I am capturing footage using the Windows camera app. Now, if it works with the Windows camera app, it'll work with OBS Studio or pretty much any other capture software you want to use. Right now you're watching footage recorded directly on the Panasonic HCX-1000, and now you're watching footage captured by the Syllable USB 3 4K capture device. It's helpful to see them side by side. So on the left, this is the original Panasonic HCX-1000 footage, and on the right, what you're looking at is the captured footage from the Syllable HDMI capture device. Now, at the risk of alarming some folks, I'm going to zoom in tight on part of my face. This should give you a good comparison of the sharpness of my original camera on the left to the captured footage on the right. It's pretty obvious on that last side-by-side shot that my Panasonic HCX-1000 doesn't have the best autofocus. But the sharpness on the original footage and the captured footage are a very close match. Also, the video level was a close match. The chroma looked good, and it sounded good. The audio capture sounded good. So far, this is the best capture device I've reviewed. Now, I want to take a closer look at the scope, both the original footage and color bars. Okay, here is a shot of my original footage. Levels look good, chroma looks pretty good, and here's the capture. Now, any change you might see is probably related to the fact that I'm not picking the exact same frame in the footage each time. Let's go to color bars. There's the original color bars, and there's the capture. Video level is spot on. Chroma level is spot on. Chroma hue is spot on. So the accuracy of this capture device is quite good and will not require a lot of tweaks in post-production. Checking media info for the file created by the U900 Pro. It is MPEG 4. Format is AVC. Codec is AVC1. Video bitrate is 69.2 Mbps with 3840, height 2160, which is 4K. Frame rate is 30 frames per second. YUV 420 chroma subsampling, 8-bit depth. Audio is 2-channel stereo, 48 kilohertz. I don't own a whole lot of 4K sources, but one of them that I do own is this GooBangDoo Android streaming device. So let's take a look at some footage that I'm streaming from this and capturing with my computer. Here's a video loop that I created a while back to do 4K demonstrations. The black frame around the edge is being created by my streaming device, not the capture device. There is a quiet music passage on this footage, and it is coming through. I wanted to see how the Syllable does with other resolutions, so I'm plugging in my Atari Flashback 9. This is natively 720p. I've had issues with other capture devices using this. Let's see how the Syllable does. For some reason, I wasn't getting any game audio through the HDMI. I've had this problem with other capture devices hooked up to the Flashback 9 in the past. And also, gamers, keep in mind there is no headset input, so you'll have to do your own audio mix on the PC if you want to stream your games live. Some capture devices that do great with progressive scan struggle sometimes with interlaced footage. Well, this old Panasonic HC-V100M, I have the HDMI output set to 1080i. In fact, let's play with it a little bit. With the HC-V100M HDMI out, I'm getting some pixel issues on the footage and the audio is missing. This is an old camera and I've never attempted to use the HDMI on it before. One thing I've been checking lately is HDCP compliance. That stands for High Definition Copy Protection. Most your streaming devices, including Roku, support that. And indeed, I cannot record my Roku using the Syllable capture device. I get a warning that says HDCP protection. So in conclusion, the Syllable U900 USB 3 4K HDMI capture device had very accurate video levels, and chroma hue when capturing from my 4K video camera. It did have some issues with my Atari Flashback 9, but I've had issues with other capture devices, and a Panasonic HC-V100, which is a 10-year-old camcorder. Perhaps if I dig into the menus, I can figure out why I was having those issues. Gamers, there is no headset input, so if you want to mix your audio with game audio, you will need to do that mix on your either with an outboard mixer or in your computer. This device does respect HDCP copy protection, so if you're wanting to record copyrighted content from, say, a Roku or a Blu-ray player, you're not going to be able to do that. Now, I have Amazon affiliate link in the description of this video. If you order this device through that link, I receive a small commission at no additional cost to you. If you enjoyed this video, smash that like button. Thank you to my patrons for supporting this channel. And remember, stay thrifty, everyone.